Thank you very much for that, Heather. Welcome to the Just a 25-Minute Quiz, which is a quiz born out of a concept of how long can you really do a quiz for? And we thought, well, we're going to try and do a quiz to a ridiculously long length. So today we've got two contestants. We have Barry O'Donnell and we've got Linda McAuliffe.
Hi.
Hello.
Can you, firstly, we'll go to you, Barry. Can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Okay, so I'm 48, living in Tralee, doing a radio course, and it's really enjoyable, great crack. Like the music, listen to a lot of radio, like going out walks, fresh air, travelling. Yeah, it's good fun. And quizzes, I love quizzes.
Yeah, well, hopefully you'll love this quiz. We do actually have a prize at the end, a mystery prize donated by a mystery donor.
Oh.
So, Linda, can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
So, I'm originally from Cork, living in Tralee for the last few years. And just like Barry, I love quizzes. Not very good at them, but I do love them. Doing the radio course as well alongside Barry and enjoying it very much too. And I work at Pinnies at weekends, so I hope there's some Pinnies questions in there.
Yeah, I have some questions set specifically for the Pinnies, specific to the Killarney shop.
Oh, gee. Oh!
I actually don't. That is a lie.
Oh,
like some of the other promises I made, but there is a prize. There is a prize.
Oh, my God. This makes it all the more competitive, Barry. I'm sorry.
It does. That's okay.
So to keep this fair, I have prepared two sets of questions. So I was going to let you guys pick who got which question set. So we're going to start with the greatest thing ever on radio, a coin toss. So, Linda, would you like to choose heads or tails?
Heads.
It is tails. So, sorry, couldn't tell. Didn't recognize that coin. Couldn't tell which side was which. So, Barry, I have question set A and question set B. Which one would you like to choose?
I'll go for A.
A. Excellent. So, I have four categories to begin with. So we've got general knowledge, we've got film knowledge, we've got musical knowledge, and then just to spice it up, I've got animal knowledge. Oh. So I let you choose which category we begin with, Barry.
Okay. Can we begin with general knowledge?
Yes. So, first question is, I just get to the back page. Which soup is a delicacy in Chinese cuisine made from the salivary excretions of the swiftlet?
Dave!
It's not miso soup, is it?
It is not miso soup. I'm going to give Linda a chance to steal, although I suspect from your reaction you might not also know this one.
There is no such soup.
The answer is bird's nest soup.
Got me there.
It's a Chinese thing where there's a bird who basically spits on a wall and makes a nest for itself, and Chinese people peel the spit off and cook it into a soup. And apparently it gives you so many positive health benefits, it basically makes you immortal. It might not be correct. Next question, Barry.
Okay.
Can you name the four main human blood groups?
Is it O, A, and...
Correct.
A and B.
Yes.
Yeah.
And there's one more.
Okay, C.
It's a good guess.
Okay.
Do you know the final blood group, Linda?
It's a double one anyway.
It is a double one.
AC?
No. The final blood group is AB.
Oh.
Okay.
Another question, Barry. How many people are needed for a three-legged race? Have a think about this before you answer.
Okay. Two people?
Incorrect. Linda's looking ready to steal.
I was going to say two people as well.
Also incorrect.
It's true.
Yeah, the answer to the question is four.
Four people? Wow.
Because...
Oh, yeah. You need
two
competitor.
Teams to have a race. Okay?
It's a tricky one, though.
Next question. What is the average temperature of the human body in degrees centigrade?
Okay.
So if a doctor put a thermometer in your ear and you were this temperature, you would said to be healthy.
Okay, I think I know a Fahrenheit figure. Is that 98.3? I'm not sure if that's Celsius or Fahrenheit.
That would be Fahrenheit. Okay. I have no idea what the conversion rate is between Celsius and Fahrenheit. 98.3, you said.
Yeah.
I will Google that before the end of the show and I'll let you know if you get that point.
Okay.
I'll give Linda a chance to steal.
37.
It is 37. That's controversial. We'll see how that goes towards the end of the show. Next question is a general knowledge question, but it is sports themed. What was the first country to win the World Cup twice?
Could it be England?
Going to give Linda a chance to steal?
Sorry, guys.
Brazil?
No, the answer is Italy.
Oh, wow.
Next question. This one is hard. I shouldn't have put this one down. What did Sir Christopher Cockerell invent? I'll give you a clue. It's a vehicle. No idea?
Barry, it's your question.
A motor car?
Incorrect. Linda, chance to steal?
Bicycle?
No, he invented the hovercraft.
Wow.
Next question. Name one of the two tiles that have the highest score in Scrabble, Barry.
Okay, I'll try a Z.
Correct. Bonus, can you name the other one?
Y?
Incorrect. Linda?
A?
No, it's a Q.
Okay.
But don't worry about that, you got the question right. Next question. Which three-digit number refers to the not found error message that you get on websites? When something is not found, it gives you a three-digit numerical error.
Is it a 501?
It is not. Linda, chance to steal?
401?
Oh, close. It's 404. Error 404 not found. Final question on general knowledge. In the song The 12 Days of Christmas, what did my true love send to me on the ninth day, Barry?
Four French hens? No.
No? It's nine somethings.
Nine. Nine turtle doves?
Incorrect.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay. Linda?
No, not a clue.
No idea?
I'm not even going to guess.
It is nine ladies dancing. So I'm going to count those up in a bit, but we're going to go on to Linda's general knowledge questions. How do you feel about this now, Linda?
Awful. If they're general knowledge, I don't know what to say about my general knowledge.
Can you name the two main ingredients of pasta?
Flour.
Correct.
And... water.
Yes, flour and water. Well done. Next question. How did Vincent van Gogh sign his paintings? He had a particular signature that he would write on all of his paintings.
Just V?
It was Vincent.
Oh, that's actually interesting.
Should have actually given Barry a chance to steal there. Sorry, Barry.
Oh, no, that's okay.
Did you know that one?
No, I didn't know.
Okay. Quiz working on the honor system. What is the Mexican food gazpacho, Linda?
Gazpacho. Is it a sauce?
It is not. Barry, chance to steal.
It's a soup.
It is a soup.
Oh, a soup.
Yes, it is a cold soup. Linda, what is the second smallest county in Ireland?
Second smallest.
Yeah, I think we all know the smallest. Let's pretend I do. What is the second smallest?
I am going to go with Kevin.
Incorrect. Barry, chance to steal. What is the smallest, second smallest county in Ireland?
Okay, I know Louth is the smallest. I think it's Leitrim.
What I have down here is Carlow.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Carlow.
But yeah, we all know Louth is the smallest. Next question, Linda. The Dewey Decimal System is used to categorise what?
God. Is there such a thing?
There is. It would be an unfair question if it wasn't.
To categorise... No, I've no idea.
Barry, chance to steal?
Is it a scientific measurement?
It is not a scientific measurement. It's used to categorise a particular thing.
Okay.
The answer is books. Oh. The Dewey Decimal System is used in every library. It's the numbers that are on the spine of every book.
ISBN numbers, yeah.
Linda... which story begins, all children grow up except one?
Rip Van Winkle?
Incorrect. Barry, chance to steal.
Okay. Can I ask you the question once more?
Which story begins, all children except one grow up?
Hansel and Gretel.
Incorrect. The answer is Peter Pan.
Okay.
Linda. I apologise for this question. How many sides has a heptagon?
Oh, this is an easy one. Heptagon. I'm guessing roughly around 14.
14. Incorrect. Okay. Barry.
8.
Also incorrect. It's 7.
Oh.
Linda. Etymology is the study of what?
Earth.
Incorrect. Barry, chance to steal.
Pass.
Etymology is the study of the origin of language and words.
Ah.
Linda, how many digits is in a Visa card number?
In a Visa card? Lots, anyway.
Or any credit card number. They all have the same amount of numbers.
16.
Correct.
Woohoo!
Final question in your general knowledge. Which Kerry place name means height of the graves?
Which Kerry place name?
Yeah.
Artfort?
Yes! Wow. Excellently done. Nice. As the person who prepared the question, I can honestly say I would never have gotten that.
Ard Eartha, yeah.
So I'm going to segue now into a section called Famous Doppelgangers. Oh. I have gotten some songs by some famous Barrys and some famous Lindas.
Ah.
Oh.
And I am going to play one of those songs now. So let me see now, Linda, if you can guess what this song is. Yes, correct. It is Linda Martin.
Sometimes when I look at you, you take my kiss away.
For a bonus point, before she gets to the chorus, can you tell me the name of that song?
Why Me?
Yes. Well done. Now, Barry.
Okay.
Excuse me for 1 second while I cue up a song by a famous Barry.
Is it Barry Manilow?
It is.
That's a good guess.
For a bonus point, can you tell me the song? I have not actually played yet.
He should get a bonus point for that.
No, I don't know the name of the song.
Well, if you play it, that would be difficult. Yeah, the PC's not working.
That's okay. That's okay.
Keep going over to the right. Press on.
Now the cart's not loading it, but yeah, you know, Barry, I gotta go ahead. I'll give you both points. It was the Coco Cabana.
Oh, Coco Cabana, yeah, pretty good.
But yeah, you get both points for thinking beforehand. So, Linda, you chose general knowledge. Barry,
okay.
Would you like to choose the next set of questions? I think this will probably be the last set of questions based on the time we have so far. So we have musical questions, we have film questions, and we have animal questions.
Okay. Will I go with film questions?
Sure.
Okay.
So, question one. Bradley Cooper's directorial debut sees his character fall in love with a younger singer played by Lady Gaga. What is the name of this film?
Oh, God. Last November.
That is... That wasn't a guess. That's when it came out. Yes.
Unfortunately, I've forgotten the name of it.
Okay. Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, Linda looked like she was primed to steal. Owen Fitz has walked into the studio.
Question again? I think I know it.
The question is, should you speak on mic when a quiz is going on?
Yes.
No, the answer is no.
A Star Is Born.
Oh,
correct. Yes.
Ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding. I forgot.
Shallow. I had in my head was Shallow.
Okay, question two. Which 2018 horror film is a spin-off of 2016's The Conjuring 2?
I don't know, sorry.
That's okay, that's a bit of an obscure one. Linda?
No.
It's called The Nun.
Oh, yeah.
Who stars, Barry, as the titular character in the DC film Aquaman?
Oh, pass as well.
Pass. Linda?
No.
Jason Momoa.
Never even heard of him.
He was in Game of Thrones and Stargate Atlantis.
Oh, okay.
And I think Hawaii Five-0. Barry.
Okay.
Which British actress played Mary Poppins in the Mary Poppins remake?
Pass. I haven't seen too many movies last year.
Linda?
I'm going to say Kate Winslet.
No, it was Emily Blunt. Barry.
Okay.
Which 2018 comedy sees high school dropout Teddy Walker, played by Kevin Hart, try to get his general equivalence diploma?
Another pass, I'm afraid.
Say that again?
2018 comedy sees high school dropout Teddy Walker, played by Kevin Hart, attempt to achieve his general equivalency diploma.
What's the name of the film, is that?
Yeah.
Teddy Walker. I know that's Teddy Walker, but... No, I'm going to kick myself with this.
It's Night School.
Okay.
Barry, can you name a recent film about the life and times of the musician Elton John? Linda's very excited now.
I don't know. I know it's only in the cinema last week. Pass. Sorry.
Pass. Linda?
Rocketman.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. And brief segment now to end off the films that I've called Jennifer Knowledge. So this is just a question about Jennifer Lawrence. Name as many films as you can, Barry, from the series in which Jennifer Lawrence shoots things with a bow and arrow.
Pass, I'm afraid.
None of them? Okay.
No.
Linda?
No.
None of them? Okay.
Could I try Robin Hood?
It's not Robin Hood.
Okay.
The answers were The Hunger Games.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So, Linda, your film questions. True or false? Dwayne The Rock Johnson appeared in the 2018 sequel to 1995's Jumanji.
True.
It is true. Which former US office star directed the horror film A Quiet Place?
Not a clue.
John Krasinski. It's another question. Bradley Cooper plays Jackson Maine in which 2018 musical film?
Musical film.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with Any.
Any? Incorrect. Barry, I think you said it there.
A Star is Born.
It is A Star is Born.
Same one. That is... I need my producer in here.
Okay. Did you see A Star is Born?
Yeah.
Okay.
I love A Star is Born. I love it.
Well,
I love Bradley Cooper as well.
A Star is Born is going to have to be content with the fact that you don't love it that much. Linda, which US dark comedy sees Jason Bateman and Rachel McAdams family members kidnapped by burglars?
Panic Room?
Nope. Barry, chance to steal?
I'm pass, I'm afraid.
It's Game Night. Linda, the film Creed 2 is the 8th installment of which film franchise?
Film franchise?
Yes. It's the 8th in the series, but it's called Creed 2.
Not a clue.
Barry, chance to steal?
Is it one of the Saw horror movies?
It is not one of the Saw films. It is the 8th Rocky film.
Ah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Linda, similar to Barry's last question, can you name a recent film about the life and times of the musical group Queen?
I am going to go with Bohemian Rhapsody.
Correct.
Woohoo!
Okay, and then on to your segment known as Jennifer Knowledge. Can you name the films in which Jennifer Lawrence plays a blue shape-shifting superhero?
Superwoman.
Incorrect. Barry.
Superman?
No, incorrect also. Barry, chance to steal.
Is it some Avengers? No.
Close, not quite. It is the...
Marvel.
Kind of close, but still not quite. It's the X-Men prequel films.
Okay.
Nah, we're too old for that, you see. Me and Barry.
That's okay. I have another famous doppelganger question for you.
Okay.
So we're going to lead again with Linda. So let me just load this here. Linda, can you tell me which famous Linda this is? I'm going to fade it down a little bit. Can you still hear it?
I'm going to go with Linda Cash.
Incorrect. Barry, chance to steal.
I'll go with Evans, Linda Evans.
Incorrect. It is Linda Ronstadt.
Oh.
Famous chooser of the battle between the Plough King and Mr. Plough. Linda, I'll give you a bonus point. Do you know the name of the song?
Let me hear it.
She has only said it about 25 times. You can jump in and steal as well, Barry, if you want.
Okay. It's so easy.
Correct.
I'm shocked. Daylight robbery.
All right, I'm going to fade that down. So we have our famous other Barry.
Okay.
Now I just need to fade up this. So as before, Barry, 1 point for the name and then 1 point again for the name of the song.
I'm afraid I have to pass on.
Oh, no, no, wait, there's no singing even yet, so I'll give you right till he starts in.
That's good to hear.
You'll,
there might be a cue in this. Definitely 1970s, anyway.
I would love to tell you if you're right or wrong, but I have no idea.
Second,
he's taking his time.
I think he likes taking his time. I'll give it over to Linda.
Let me jump halfway into the song.
I'm afraid not. Sorry.
To be fair, Barry, it looks like I've queued up an instrumental.
I was just going to say, I think that's an instrumental, Barry. Barry. I don't know any Barry singers. Barry.
There's a TV program called Barry, but...
Is he Irish?
He is not Irish. He is American, and he is pretty funky.
Barry Cohen?
No.
I don't know if that's even a name of a singer. I think that's a guy I just know.
We got it together, didn't we?
He is funky.
Nobody but you... And me.
I'm sorry.
We've got it together, baby.
Anybody who's ever watched Ally McBeal should know this song. They only played it 100 times.
My
first,
my last, my everything. No.
No?
No.
Oh, sorry.
The answer is Barry White.
Oh, yeah.
And the song is Just the Way You Are. So I'm going to fade that down. So we're out of time. I'm going to call it there. Going to be honest with you guys, I can't count the questions and call them out at the same time. So I have no idea who won. But the prize was a fruit scone.
Oh my God, a fruit scone.
Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and let you guys split that.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. A fruit scone. Barry, that's our breakfast sorted for tomorrow.
That's it?
Yeah.
And Dave, that was a fantastic quiz show today.
Good,
thanks
yeah.
very much.
Thank you very much for coming.
It was
coming
a bit
out.
Hard, but...
Yeah, but the next time I won't choose films, I'll choose sport.
Yeah, to make it easy, I did take the animal questions off of a children's website, so I'd have expected both of you to get like top marks there, but we didn't get to the animal questions.
Okay. Well, are we invited on tomorrow's show?
We can talk about that afterwards if you want to be. We could run through the rest of the questions if you want to do it again.
I think we need episode 2.
I'll tally up the totals and we can keep going. So that's all from us. Thank you very much. And we're going to leave you here with Aerosmith, Dude Looks Like a Lady.